is Aja Monet, and I don't camouflage. For many reasons. One being, I like being individual. I like different colors, multi-environments. So don't camouflage. Be yourself.
Not camouflaging is kind of, you know, using the colors of life to kind of just make your own masterpiece. Walk in the footsteps of greatness, you know? I think I recognize the history of Paris and France and the artists that were coming there, so there was this infatuation with that, but also things that I was dealing with back home that I didn't really have the space to like process, you know, as a young woman and in an economy that was struggling and just coming out of grad school and figuring out what you were going to do. I thought if there was any opportunity to go with nothing to tie me down, no relationship, no kids, why not go now, you know? And it's a space that I knew someone in. And I really did look to James Baldwin a lot as an inspiration for that, because he had left when he was like 24, or right before his 24th birthday, and he was like, had like $40 in his pocket, and he knocked on Richard Wright's door, and like Richard Wright let him stay. And it was kind of like the same situation where I kind of like had nothing, and I'd finished, and I was right before my 24th birthday, and I was at Saul's house, like, what's good? Like, you know, I'm here. And he was really supportive about that transition, but I think there was a multitude of things that allowed that trip to be great. Nobody in my family ever really had been to France or Europe, you know, and I think there was something unique about bringing my bloodline to places that they've never been before. When you take yourself outside of your environment, when you dare not to camouflage, you see yourself in multitudes. Like, you start to experience yourself in other areas and in other ways, and other people engage with you with a newness and a freshness and an inquiry that you hadn't experienced before. So like the language barrier and the cultural differences, they've really forced me to like really address what it was, whatever it was that I was existing as, in the presence that I had thought I knew what I was and what I was going to be. And being in another country really allowed me to like break out of a shell of whatever it was that I was to other people back home and whoever I needed to be. No one knew me as a poet, really. Like, you know, no one knew exactly what I was doing there. They kind of would hear a little bit about it. They knew who I was staying with, maybe. But meeting people as just like new spirits and souls, like just coming into contact with them and seeing how they treat you outside of whatever they know you to be, or whatever judgments they have, also it just really allowed me to be different, you know, and to understand what it meant to be American outside of the context of living in America, and to be a New Yorker outside of the context of living in New York, and what that meant for other people. It challenged all sorts of stereotypes, and I creatively was inspired to do things that I never really felt the space to do it back home, because artists are always struggling to make money and make product and, you know, capitalize off of their ventures. And I think when I was in France, I was just allowed to like breathe for a moment and create. And I started working on a science fiction book that like I had the dream of doing, but I didn't really have that altered experience to allow me to channel that creative like hunger to do it, you know? So it gave me that space. I'm still discovering things about myself in that process. I think you always are. And when you talk about it, the actual meaning starts to fleet for you, because you're like, how do I catch those ideas and those experiences in words? It's not always easy. I'm constantly allowing myself to be in awe of things around me. And when I meet people and when I spend time with people, I really enjoy the exchange that takes place, the give and take of energy, and like the sacredness of that, and how, like, you know, I was always just inquisitive about people and things, and I think the curiosity is what fuels you to be open to the idea of being inspired by something that ordinarily probably could just be seen as however, you know. It's just how you, the lens that you bring to it, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, for example, like, you know, you have a camera that you're shooting me on, but it's like, the more you allow yourself to experience, the more lenses you get, you know. And it's like, you can get more defined with it, you know. You can get like a little jaded if you want, you know when you can go into something and be like really, really particular about it, or you can move away and just be really removed and detached. And I think I'm always trying to like allow myself to be in awe of life, you know, like constantly seeing that perspective is what changes anything. So creativity is like directly affected by you allowing something to like channel through you and use that to like whatever it is, whether you're cooking a plate of food, you know, whether you're like showering yourself, whether you're like decorating your room. It's like all those things, I'm learning the creativity of that, and it helps me with the writing, and it helps me with the loving, and it helps me with you know, everything in life, you know. It's just seeing the creativity of it all. If everybody engaged with life as artists, man, this world would be fresh, you know.